We're back here in Wales now after a pretty good 2012 season. Did probably one of my best years overall so far, so now we're trying to sort out what's going on for next year training wise and looking forward to getting going again right now. So. Mega gets quite a lot of use really in Wales. We've got a lot of trail centres and kind of natural cross country and stuff, so after the season finished I had a bit of a chance to ride it a bit more again, and last weekend I did my first enduro race over at Hopton, so that was pretty cool. It handled it pretty well, ended up third. So
we're in Innerleithen, Scottish Borders, stayed here for roughly about, must be coming up 9 years now, moved from Edinburgh. Moved here with mum and dad, and it's a nice place, it's out of the way, not much to do apart from ride your bike, but it's ideal for me.
Yeah, basically Mega's replaced an XC bike, and although it's got a bit more travel and that, it's been good. I mean, sometimes it's better training, having a little bit more traveling, so you got to work harder to get to the top of the hills, but it's always worth it once you get up there. The downhills are so much better on it. It's just like once you get up there, you can let it rip on the way down, put the seat down and you're off.
Went up to Glen Tress and you know, I haven't been up there in a while. Just did some kind of single track, sort of stuff on the Mega, on the Nukeproof Mega. Good fun, just it was soaking wet, so made it that a little bit better. Kind of being honest, before it went wet, it just makes it a bit more interesting.
Yeah, we're at Nukeproof for bringing out a slightly revised frame, but there's two models available now. There's going to be the Mega with 130 travel and one with 160, so you're kind of separating it a little bit more. So for like UK trail centres and stuff, which is kind of what I do a lot over winter because we've got a lot around here. I think the 130 one's going to be ideal. You're going to be able to carry a lot more speed everywhere and be like a faster biker in the UK. But then obviously if you want to go, if you're doing a lot more riding abroad and stuff, and you've got the 160 one, it's still capable of going uphills fine, but you can have even more fun on the downhill.